Welcome back to the channel, everybody. So, in today's video, we're going to be cleaning up this cluster of quartz crystals. You can see the brown, which is iron oxide, on it. And we're going to be testing some different chemicals. So, one of the things that you often see suggested for cleaning this is iron out, muriatic acid, vinegar, those types of things. I have all of those things, so let's see which one works best. To do so, I'm going to smash this thing into three chunks because I don't really care about it, and then we can test all three chemicals on the same rock. So let me crack this guy. Here's our three little chunks here, and I broke that open with a little 3-pound persuader. So let's head outside and we will... So I'm going to be using the distilled white vinegar, some iron out, some acid magic muriatic acid, and to neutralize the solution I got this gold pan with some baking soda in it. And as always, this is a do as I say, not as I do channel. Make sure that you have gloves and glasses, and or at least safety squints, and don't be stupid with your acid. So the iron out is a powder, the other two are liquids, and I'm not gonna really worry a whole lot about how much I put in there, because what I found with iron out is you can put too much and it just won't dissolve into solution, and it's totally fine. So let's start this up. I forgot that I need some water for the iron out. And super stirring stick. There's that. And throw the muriatic acid one in here. Maybe a little bit more, top these guys off. Or better yet, I'll put a rock under it so it's fully submerged here and will tilt under. Hey, there we go. That works. And we're going to let this cook. Right now it is 8:43 in the a.m. And I'm going to let this run for, well, couple hours or so, and we'll check back in on it. You can kind of see the muriatic acid working, all the yellow coming off of it. The iron out, not a whole lot happening, and pretty much nothing for the vinegar. That's about 5 minutes or so after I started. It's been exactly an hour, and you can see some discoloring to the muriatic acid. Not a whole lot going on the iron out. And basically nothing going on with the distilled vinegar. And the sun is about to hit this, which, acids always work better when they're warm. We're going to be leaving this out here probably all day at this point. And we'll check it. I mean, so far you can kind of see there's a little pile of material in the muriatic acid and the iron out. Well, I mean, really, you're kind of getting little pieces breaking off of all of them. So, we'll see. It's a little after 5 o'clock now. Put these in a little bit before 8 a.m. So, we're going to throw these in some baking soda water to neutralize the acid. And then we'll hit them with a wire brush and we can look at what we have here. That really turned very yellow. But throw that in there. That's the iron out one, and the vinegar. So I'll let these soak in there for a while, and then we'll dump the acid in here, and hit them with the wire brush and see where they're at. So these have been sitting in the baking soda water for a little over an hour now, and they're pretty good and neutralized. So I'm going to take them out, wash them off, and hit them with the wire brush, and we will head back into the shop and look at what the winner is here. Here is the first one that was done in the distilled white vinegar. Now, I'm not exactly sure why people suggest this is a way of cleaning rocks. It's not actually that great. And I think, well, when you see the next two, yeah, you'll probably agree. Right here, we have the one that was done in iron out. And you can still see there's some spots. And that's pretty normal with this type of thing. It does often require two soaks, and I should have probably been watching it a little bit more. I mean, I could definitely go throw this back in there and make this a little bit nicer, but I would say it's a pretty good mediocre finish on this. The iron out, it's like a sodium sulfite, so it pretty much just dissolves the iron oxide on here. It does it really slowly, and you don't really need to neutralize it, even though it's a good idea. Now, this the video may not do it justice, but clearly the muriatic acid removed the iron oxide better than everything else. However, there's a slight yellow tinge to this. Maybe you can see that a little more side by side. It's possible that I could then throw this in some iron out for a short period of time and get some of that yellow coloration out of this. That might be something that I do in the future. I think, generally speaking, cost-wise and ease of use, iron out might be the very best for cleaning your quartz crystals that have that rusty iron oxide, which is really common. And, you know, you can do this. You can use iron oxide in the house. It's pretty safe, obviously. You don't want to, you know, be huffing the fumes. But it's good. It's very good. And, you know, it doesn't make this fragile. So that's where we are with that. I hope you found this video to be useful and informative. I have a lot more videos here on the channel, kind of like this, where we talk about everything rock related, and I kind of get into some of the science behind it and some of the geology, that good stuff. So definitely subscribe and hit that thumbs up button, and I will catch you on the next video.